Lewis Hamilton's Mercedes contract negotiations have been placed on hold as Mercedes may sever ties with him over a $681 million rumor. The seven-time world champion's contract ends after the 2023 Formula One season, and there has been widespread speculation that he may refuse to sign a new agreement if Mercedes fails to reverse their downturn. Mercedes and Hamilton discussed a new deal during the launch of their car a few weeks ago, but things have since changed. Stick around for more details. With the excessive expense of the F1 star's next deal, Lewis Hamilton and Mercedes may part ways at the end of this year. Hamilton's current contract expires at $52 million each season at the end of 2023, leaving his future with the team in doubt. With daylight behind Red Bull in the race for the Drivers' and Constructors' Championship this season, the clock is ticking on Hamilton's bid for a record-breaking eighth world title. In the opening two races of the season in Bahrain and Saudi Arabia, the 38-year-old finished fifth, 51 seconds behind winner Max Verstappen with teammate George Russell seventh. When questioned about the prospect of making new arrangements for Mercedes's 2024 driver lineup, team principal Toto Wolff refused to speculate. "There is no point talking about the driver situation for 2024," the Austrian said. "That is far too early. We have to all push in the same direction, the drivers, engineers, and management, rather than throwing in the towel. We have never done that, and we will not do that now." Before things started going wrong. As discussions on the deal began in early February of this year, Mercedes CEO Toto Wolff stated that an agreement would be signed over the winter, but no new details had emerged. There were even suspicions that talks had halted when Hamilton revealed they had not started last month. But as the covers came off the Mercedes W14, the two appeared to have finally begun planning their future. When pressed on Hamilton's new contract, Wolff replied, "We've made a couple of these contracts in the past and they change little, so it's not normally complicated apart from the obvious things. We had our first conversation. However, I don't want to commit to a timeline because it isn't important for him or us. It runs a full year and we'll find the right time." The Austrian stressed that talks were not dragging on and that the relationship would continue. "We've always found solid solutions that reflect his worth to the club and the sport," he continued. "And on the other hand, I think Mercedes is the place he wants to be. They have never been contested issues. It was never an issue for us to work things out throughout the winter before racing, since it was always evident that they would. Sitting down is not a priority because this will be a long journey. Will Mercedes pay Hamilton an absolute fortune to stay on? The collaboration between drivers and engineers may be revitalized, allowing Hamilton a chance to realize his dream. What seems clear, to me at least, is that Hamilton will find a way. He will rage against the dying of the light. He will agitate against the disadvantage of an underperforming car," Mercedes's boss said. "He will continue to bet on himself against the rigors of time and mechanical underperformance, seeking out the glimmer of opportunity that he's so often found on the track. It may manifest itself in a new design or a new team, but I don't see this story petering out just yet." Mercedes had earlier rejected claims that Hamilton was ready to sign a pound, $62 million a year contract due to measures to deal with the unfounded news that had made its way into public space. On the other hand, Wolff has previously acknowledged that his next negotiations may detail Hamilton's post-F1 future in the form of ambassadorial responsibilities. Hamilton reiterated his prior assertions that he would like to stay at Mercedes indefinitely after debuting the new car at Silverstone. The Mercedes boss also reacted angrily to suggestions that the German firm demonstrates race-winning potential before signing a contract. He explained, "For the team, I don't need them to prove anything to me. We've proved time and time again over the years that we have strength in depth. We still have all these incredibly talented individuals within the team. As I said, you don't lose that ability. We're continuing to try to improve our processes. We're continuing to try to be smarter in how we approach things and with our communication. I think there's the best harmony within the team that I've seen in all these years. We've got a real, fresh, young group of engineers and people that have just come into the team over the past year as well. So it's an exciting time for the team, and I don't plan on being anywhere else." The potentiality of it all. Hamilton was yet to sign a new contract, but the thought of having to pay his next contract might see Mercedes say farewell to the seven-time world champion, according to the Times. Earlier this year, it was reported that Hamilton's new contract would be worth $217.8 million over 2 years. According to 20 Minutes, Hamilton is exploring another contract as a Mercedes ambassador once he retires, worth $389.6 million over 10 years. If Hamilton signs these contracts, he will make $680.9 million over the following 13 years. Jim Ratcliffe, the founder of chemical conglomerate Ineos, is said to have contributed heavily to the astonishing sums. Ratcliffe is also the primary sponsor of Mercedes-AMG Petronas, with a 33% share in the team. According to Matthew Syed of The Times, many Hamilton haters believe Mercedes would be better suited investing that money elsewhere, and Hamilton could join Ferrari. This is why the question of his future is so tantalizing, Syed wrote. He benefited hugely from the world-class engineering at Mercedes in the good years and doubtless felt a sense of loyalty. With one season left on his contract, he may wonder whether a different ride out there may enable him to leave on a high. It's unlikely he would gain a berth at Red Bull, but the prospect of Hamilton and Verstappen going head-to-head in the same car, the aging maestro against the audacious pretender, is a storyline that could take the sport to a new level. There's also a chance that Mercedes can get their act together and find a way of getting the car up to speed, Ratcliffe concluded. F1 presses on currently. F1 has restated that Lewis Hamilton's F1 title may be removed as Max Verstappen clashes with Brundle. Lewis Hamilton's Formula One championship could be jeopardized when Felipe Massa hinted he might sue over the outcome of the 2008 season. It comes after former F1 president Bernie Ecclestone stated that the Ferrari driver should have won the championship after a race result was annulled. The ex-F1 CEO said executives were made aware of the Nelson Piquet race-fixing scandal, but decided not to alter the outcome to avoid a scandal. But the words have prompted Massa to investigate the matter, which might have serious consequences for Hamilton. Meanwhile, Max Verstappen has expressed his displeasure with Sky Sports F1 analyst Martin Brundle. According to the Red Bull star, throwing red flags for Kevin Magnussen's collision in Australia was needless. On the other hand, Brundle believes the move was necessary to protect fans positioned just meters from the track's edge. Max Verstappen is lauded for dodging Hamilton's rocket. Meanwhile, drama constantly unfolds at the square as Red Bull chief Christian Horner stated that Max Verstappen did well to avoid contacting Lewis Hamilton at the Australian Grand Prix. As the pair contended for the position on the first lap, the Red Bull chief accused the Mercedes driver of unleashing a rocket. The two Mercedes drivers were fast starting, Horner explained. On the first lap, they were both aggressive, with Max showing remarkable patience not to become troubled. George got a blinder, and he just sent it down into the first corner, so Max got out of that, and by getting out of it to allow him through, that then compromised him through T2, and then Fernando and Lewis got a run on him, and Lewis sent a missile down into T3. Again, I thought he showed great patience to get out of the way. It was hard racing between the two of them. If you have reached this far, like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, and turn on the notification for more videos like this. See you next time.